Hi, I'm Security Management Editor-in-Chief Teresa Anderson. Reputation is important in any industry, but here at GSX 22, people trusting you to keep them secure is everything. How to build trust in your security brand, now on SM Live. We're here with Lida Citroen of Lida 360. Lida is a personal branding and reputation expert, and she's presenting a game changer session here at GSX 2022. Welcome to SM Live, Lida.
Thank you. I am so excited to be here in Atlanta.
Thank you. So, trust is an issue in the security industry. How is trust a part of also personal branding and career promotion?
Well, if you think of it, I mean, trust is your word, right? So whether it's trust in the systems you're implementing or the processes you're designing or the things that you vouch for and the things that you ascribe to, your name and your reputation goes along with trust. And I love to say that security professionals are really in the trust business. Because if you advocate for something, if you believe in something, or you want to push forward on something, you really have to get people to trust you. And really, trust comes from credibility. If you tell me what you're going to do and then you do it, I'll learn to trust you.
Absolutely. Now, should security professionals care more about their reputation and branding now than they did in the past?
I think so. I think social media added a whole new wrinkle into how we promote ourselves, how people know us. But it's not even just that. I think competition changed. Competition during the pandemic, all of a sudden people were being, competing against others from around the world rather than just around the corner or within their expertise. So because of competition, because of things like social media, I do think that security professionals are benefiting from thinking more about reputation.
Right, so some folks in the security profession like to be behind the scenes a little bit. Now, should they also be concerned about their public persona?
Well, and that's often a confusion because we think of personal branding and reputation management as being out front, being visible, but it's really about how the people that know you think of you. So even if you're behind the scenes, do the right people know you for the right reasons, and are they supporting and trusting you for what you stand for and what you offer? So even if you're behind the scenes, having a really strong brand and something that you're in control of is advantageous.
So you mentioned social media, we can't get away from it. What about those people who really aren't that involved on social media? How can they control their narrative?
Well, and that's just one of the tools that we use to control narrative, right? So when I wrote the book, Control the Narrative, which I'll be signing tomorrow here, one of the things that we think about are relationships, the people that know us, the people that advocate and endorse us, the way that we speak about ourselves, our own narrative. There's also social media, but there's executive presence, there's the way that we carry ourselves. So social media is one piece of the marketing puzzle. It's not everything.
That's good to hear, actually. There's sometimes a belief in professional circles that if you do good work and you keep your head down, you'll be rewarded. Is that still true?
You know, if only, right? Because the day used to be you showed up on time, you did good work, like you said, and then at the end they gave you a gold watch. Today, it's not just about competency or being on time and on budget. It's about recognizing that other people are mindful of how they're positioning themselves. Other people are being proactive in how they position themselves. Competency isn't a differentiator today. It's an expected.
Yeah, that makes sense. So as you know, here at GSX, we're global. Is self-promotion a uniquely Western concept?
I get that question a lot because people think it's the American bravado. My clients are all over the world, from Spain to Switzerland, every country in between, Canada, United States, Asia, Australia. And everywhere, we're trying to stand out for what we want to be known for. Now, cultural nuance and cultural narrative definitely plays a part, but think about the security professionals that are here today, whether they're in person working with a global audience or they're online working with international influences, we all have to be mindful that standing out from the competition in this huge world that became really small is important.
Yeah, we are all global all the time, aren't we? So I know that you work a lot with those in the military or transitioning out of the military. How do people in this position leverage their brand and reputation in the security industry?
It's tricky for military. If you think about the military as a different culture, a different language, a different work style, one of the predominant values of the military is service before self, which means it's not about me, it's about all of those I serve alongside. That's the opposite of personal branding. So one of the things that veterans coming into the securities industry have to recognize is it's not about being arrogant, but it is about letting people know who you are, what you can offer beyond just your competency, and where you really want to add value. The wonderful quality that the military bring into this industry is that they're very mission driven. And when you tell them your job is to keep people safe, they get on board, they get it. So wonderful audience if any of your members are looking to attract more talent.
Absolutely. Thank you so much, Lida. This was a great discussion.
Thank you. It's wonderful to talk to you.
So Lida will be signing her book, Control the Narrative, The Executive's Guide to Building, Pivoting, and Repairing Your Reputation, today from 11 a.m. to noon at the GSX bookstore. So be sure to stop by and pick up your copy.